Dr. Mansingh, let me start with you. As things become clearer that there's going to be absolutely no clarity when it comes to how art will evolve from here on, how do you perceive this space? And then, of course, we'll come to the conversation around how artists will also need some hand-holding going forward. But how do you view this space right now, ma'am, this present time?
Yes. It's a huge question, and I cannot answer it like an affirmative, decisive response. Yeah, as you said, hand-holding. I don't think much hand-holding has been done anyway. And most of us, small and big, who are running institutions, who have groups, musicians, of course, have it easier because they have their individual students. And as and when, then they get their accompanying musicians to play on the platform. But for dancers, it's very difficult. I'm specifically bringing dance in the context because it's a very different art form. And so far, everything is being put in the same basket. Dancer needs continuous practice with her musicians. There is a group, so the group repertory also needs to be in continuous practice. New choreographies have to be done. The costumes, I think the musicians don't face this problem of getting costumes and getting makeup and getting the lighting properly and all. Anyway, I think cutting across all that, where the tribal groups, the folk dancers and musicians, the folk artists and the classical. Now today two of us are classical dancers and two are classical musicians. The future for us is very bleak. I'll tell you why. Because I had written to PM about a Ministry of Culture through the zonal cultural centers and through its academies, etc., reaching out to the folk and tribal groups for which they have a ready-made database, because for various melas and events and utsavs and mahotsavs, some VIP visit, etc., they are ready-made, they are invited. And this can go on, and they can be reached, and they have been reached out to. It's people like us who are the classical, in the classical genre, about which there is so much misinformation. Oh, they are elitist artists. Oh, they have everything. They don't have to worry about anything. So I think across the board, unless the corporates come in, unless government has now a policy of including us with MSME and artisans and craftspeople, because it's an unorganized sector.
Absolutely.
You know, that, yeah, it is totally unorganized. Secondly, there are all kinds of finance ministry modules.
Yes.
Like EAT and all. Even I don't know how to fill up those multiple forms.
Okay.
So even the little minuscule grants that come through the government are stopped.
Okay.
What do we do about all this? There are many problems. So the bleak future that faces us all, closed scenario, at least for 1 year. I'm not being pessimistic, I'm being realistic.
Okay.
For 1 year, I don't see anything going on unless we really push.
I understand. Okay. So that's an important point. Dr. Mansingh has reached out to the Prime Minister's office, made some very important observations and suggestions here. You know, classical music, classical dance is concerned. You know, at this time when there is so much of focus on, or should be around, building on India's soft power around the world, culture plays a pivotal role and it should be more focused.
Absolutely, 100%. And in fact, I am also against calling it soft power because it has a wrong nuance. It is a hard power, and that is how it has existed over millennia. You know, governments have come and gone, buildings have been built and they've fallen down, empires have been built and they've crashed. Our cultural traditions are still alive. And they mean so much to people, even the common man, what we call common man, in villages, in rural areas, in small towns. Everywhere, culture, in whichever form, whether it's music, whether it's devotional, whether it's dance, community dance, individual dance, rangoli, instrument making, mask making, the festivals, culture permeates each and every act in life in India. And therefore, I call it the heart power. But today, we are specifically talking about the artists, without whom art does not exist. Culture is on the shoulders of us artists.
Exactly.
And if the artists begin to wither, the institutions begin to wither, where will culture be?
Yes.
Number two, that all the time yoga, 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 I say, yes, yoga is there, but yoga is, nitya yoga is the greatest.
Yes.
The dance, the meditation, it's a dynamic meditation. Music. All this is yoga. So the lopsided view that is being presented more and more, I think that is also bringing in a lot of misinterpretation, misinformation. The harmony, the unity that has existed has to be understood. And as all my colleagues have said, culture exists on artists. Any nation's identity is on its culture. Sabhyata, civilization.
Sure. Definitely.
Yes. And so if culture is given a short shrift, all your economic policies, your industrial, your software, your IT, your science, everything is there. But there will be no prana, there'll be no spirit, no soul, no beauty. So
are you disappointed, ma'am, with so much of focus on yoga and not, let's say, on some of the other equally important aspects of our art?
I understand that yoga everyone can do. But what I'm saying is that even dance everybody was doing. Even music was a part of our traditions. Now, of course, they put on the Bollywood music for every ceremony. But why has that come? Because of lack, that lacuna has not been filled. How much can an artist do individually? We always need a supporting land, the earth, you know, on which the tree of culture can blossom. And all that was there with the corporate social responsibility, with the governments, with the people.
Yes.
And artists are hum log apna talwa ghis dete hain, gala sookh jata hai, hamare naakhun toot jate hain.
Yes.
हम पागल हो गए हैं सिखा सिखा के कर करके एंड एज वसीम जी सेड एंड आई डोंट नो व्हाट शुजात सेड आई कुडंट हियर एट ऑल प्रतिभा जी सेड दैट एनी कैलामिटी एनी इवेंट एनी वीआईपी विजिट एनी फेस्टिवल इनको बुलाओ उनको बुलाओ उनको बुलाओ उनको बुलाओ अरे भाई 150,000 में कर दो भाई ये क्या करें हमारे पास लैक्स एंड क्रोर्स आर बीइंग स्पेंट इट डज नॉट एक्रू टू आर्टिस्ट एंड सो दिस काइंड ऑफ अ प्रेजुडिस or this kind of a mindset also has to be now broken.
Absolutely.
If it's now or never.
Dr. Mansingh, I want to ask you, you said that you did reach out to the Prime Minister, to his office, to all those who really decide policy making. Any word of assurance, Dr. Mansingh, has come in that they would look into the concerns that you raised?
The first letter that went to PM himself, I think that percolated down to the Ministry of Culture, to the Minister, because till then they were just sitting quietly. And the suggestions were taken up. One could see that, he started writing to ministers, started writing to chief ministers of, you know, states and all that. And whatever zonal cultural centers can do this and not that. My point is, after listening to my colleagues, that each and every point we have emphasized that artists need to be respected and loved. And I will add one thing, that the attitude in the Ministry of Culture has to change totally. They are not doing a favor to artists. The artists are doing favor to the country and to the people of keeping the great heritage alive about which we talk ad nauseum. Our great heritage. The heritage does not live in monuments alone.
Yes.
The intangible art,
which has been
the identity of this country for millennia, that is being preserved by artists and none else.
Absolutely.
So I would say that the ministry's attitude, the bureaucratic attitude has to change. They have to respect the artists. They are not giving out doles, even that which is mandated doesn't come to us for 2 years. and we are expected to run our institutions, give accounts and everything. I think the whole thing is topsy-turvy, and there is no sunwai. There is no consultation. There is nothing. What the bureaucrats are doing within themselves, we don't know. So why don't they take artists also on board? Senior artists, absolutely, artists who have experience. Why don't they take them on board? And why is there not a pool of advice and of experience? Hmm. Because it will all benefit, not only us.
Absolutely.
But artists across the board. Yeah.
Absolutely.
And it will only, I think, add to the reputation of the not only the Ministry of Culture, not only of artists, but of the country.
Absolutely.
Because everywhere they've given big packages to culture, to the arts, except in India.